Namaskaram. Today's topic is cycloid. Cycloid, it is very, very interesting and very simple one to understand and also to construct. Okay. So first of all, let us see an example. With that example, we can understand the definition of the cycloid. So let us take this kind of, you know, a circular plate or a wheel, okay, and now let us imagine that this wheel is rolling on a straight line. This wheel is rolling on a straight line without slipping. It is rolling on a straight line without slipping. Are you able to see this red point? This point I am talking about, okay. This point is there, right? This is actually on the circumference of the circle, but to make it a little convenient to us, I am putting the same red mark here. It doesn't mean the red mark is here, it means the red mark is on the circumference of the circle, something like this. But to make it understand, so I am making like this, that's it. So now it is touching our paper, you know, that red point on the circumference of the circle is touching our paper. When it is rolling like this on the paper, you see how that red point is coming up, how that red point is coming up, and it is coming like this and touching somewhere here again, you know, this red point. Yes, students, now see the point, red point is there, right? This point is tracing, or we can say like this, cycloid is a curve traced by the point on the circumference of the circle when this circle rolls along a straight line without slipping. That is what I have shown you. Okay, this circle is rolling on the white paper here without slipping. White paper is means it means it is a straight line without slipping. It is rolling on the straight line without slipping, and this point is making or creating a curve. It is generating a curve as this this point is coming. As this wheel is moving, this point slowly comes up and reaches the peaks levels, and as it is rolling, it comes down and touches the white paper again. So I can write it as cycloid is a curve traced by a point, that red point, okay, point on the circumference of the circle on the circumference of a circle, okay, when it rolls on a straight line, on a fixed straight line, let it be fixed straight line, without slipping. This is called cycloid, okay. These cycloidal curves are commonly used in kinematics. I mean, it is the study of motion and in the mechanisms that work with the rolling contact and etc. So these curves are very much useful to in the case of study of motions and study of rolling or rolling contact and etc. So that in that case, cycloids, epicycloid, hypocycloid, these cycloidal curves are very much useful there. Okay, and let us go to the construction of the cycloid. So I mean, it is now the exam point of view I am speaking about. So in the exam point of view, you will be given only the radius of this circle. The radius of this circle or diameter of this circle, let it be 25 mm radius. So let it be small or capital R, whatever it may be. So only this radius will be given. Okay, this radius is enough to construct the cycloid. Okay, so not only this, he also asked you to draw the tangent for this particular cycloid curve. Okay, that may be around 30 mm above the directing line. Okay, so before going to construct this, let me tell you an important terminology, that directing line or directing circle. The first one is directing circle, second one is directing line. What does it mean? Directing circle means this is the wheel, this is the circle, is called directing circle. Okay, and directing line means on which line it is rolling, on which line it is rolling, that is what directing line. So my dear students and friends, if you know the diameter of the circle, you can easily find out the directing line length. How means, so we are considering only one revolution of the circle. We are considering only one revolution of the circle. Let me show you once again so that you can understand. See, what I am telling you is, this is called directing circle, and this file is there, right? This straight line, fixed straight line, is called directing line. How to know the length of the directing line in the construction of the cycloid? See, when it is rolling for one revolution, see, it is touching here. Okay, from this point to this point, the initial point to this ending point, what will be the length? That length is called the circumference of the circle. Okay, that length will be the circumference of the circle. Very simple to understand this. Okay, when this wheel is rotating for one revolution, the distance it travels is only the one for one revolution, the distance is the circumference of the circle. So the circumference of the circle is pi d. So the directing line is circumference of the circle, pi d. Okay, 2 pi r or pi d. Pi r square or pi d. Directing circle is given. The radius of or diameter of the directing circle is given. So if you know this radius, you can easily construct the line of the directing length of the directing line. You can easily understand that, easily measure that. Okay, let us go to the construction of the cycloid. So first of all, you have given only the the radius is 25 mm. Using 25 mm, you can draw a circle something like this. I am just going with my free hand, I am not using any tools here, but you can easily understand the process. But my suggestion is, when you are drawing, you just use some geometrical tools so that you can get the appropriate curve, you will get the confidence also. Okay, so minimum requirements are a pencil, eraser, drafter, scale. Okay, and drafter is very much important here, and compass. So these are the minimum basic things you need to have while drawing this cycloid. Let me put the center as C. Let me put all the names with red pen so that you can understand it. Because in the engineering drawing, you are going to get plenty of the names, the points. So let me use few different colors of pens, and now let me divide this circle. Let me divide this circle into 12 equal parts. Why 12 equal parts? Means you can also go with 4 equal parts or 8 equal parts, but if you take 12 equal parts, that is the optimum number with which you can get the beautiful curve, I mean the smooth curve. So that is the reason we are going with 12 equal parts. Instead, you can go with the 8, but it is not that much good. Number 8 is not that much good. 12 equal parts are very good. Okay, let me divide this into 12 equal parts. I have divided like this, horizontal line and vertical line. In this, you can expect 90 degrees, okay, inclination. From here, I am drawing 30 degrees, and here I am drawing, mentioning 60 degrees. So here also, this is 90, 120, 150. That's enough. 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, and let us extend this. Okay, and now we have got 12 different points. Let us give these names to these 12 different points. Let us start with 1, 2, 3, 4 5 sorry, I need to give with red pen. 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Okay, now this circle has to move, has to roll on a straight line, that you know pretty well. Okay, let me draw a straight line which is very much perpendicular to this vertical line. Okay, to this vertical line, I am drawing a line, a straight line like this, which is perpendicular to this vertical line, because it is a straight line. It is clearly mentioned in the definition, it is a fixed straight line. If it is fixed straight line, it should be perpendicular to this vertical line of that particular circle. You know, now what we need to do is, we have to divide this same, this one into 12 equal parts. Before dividing this into 12 equal parts, let us measure the length of this directing line. This is directing line. You know, what is the length of the directing line? Circumference of the circle. So what is the circumference of the circle? Pi d. Okay, pi d, pi into what is d? 50. Diameter is 50, radius is 25. So if you do like this, you get the answer is 157.08 mm. we are taking in mm. Okay, so here you have to take in terms of mm, that is 157.08 mm. Let it be P. What is P here? P is the starting point of this directing line. Q is the ending point of this directing line. Okay, let it with pencil. Okay, my dear students, I hope you are getting my point. This is 157.08 mm. You don't need to write mm always. Okay, so now what we need to do is, we have to divide the same line, 157.08 directing line, into 12 equal parts. Again, 12 equal parts. I'll tell you the reason also. So here it is one, Nana. This is one, and this is one part. This is 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Okay, 1 2 3 dash 4 dash 5 dash 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. This 12 itself is Q means this is the ending point of the directing line. Okay, so this is our directing line. I have a small little more explanation regarding this 1 dash and 1, 2 dash and 2, 3 dash and 3, 4 dash and 4, 5 dash and 5. So before going to discuss that, let me draw a center line like this. You know, the center line is also only up to this. Yes, my dear students, try to understand, try to imagine. If you want to imagine practically, you just hold a coin like this, or a plate, or a circular plate, which I have shown in the beginning. You can see that when this circle is rolling on this straight line, okay, it doesn't change the distance between this center line and this directing line. Try to imagine, for example, if you are riding a cycle, you never change, I mean, that is it doesn't change, the distance doesn't change between this radius of the wheel and the radius of the wheel and the ground or on and the road. The distance won't be changed, the distance is always same. So that I am drawing a line which is called center line, on which you can get the centers. Okay, now let me draw some vertical lines here using drafter from 1 dash 2 dash 3 dash 4 dash and so on, and let me put the names like this. C is over. So if it is coming from C1, then it becomes, 1 dash, it becomes C1, 2 dash, it becomes C2, 3 dash, C3, 4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11 and C12. What are these? As this wheel is rolling like this, so you get infinite number of centers, these divisions, but we are taking only limited number of centers and limited number of divisions. That limited number of divisions are 12 only. So 12 divisions here, 12 divisions here and 12 centers here. So now let me tell you the important point is, when center is at C, when center is C, okay, the point, let me put it with so black, let me use instead of black, let me use blue. So here is the point P. Here is the point P. When center is C, when center is C, radius is 25 mm, point is at P. Okay, when center comes here, when it is rolling, my dear students, when it is rolling, the center will change, right? But the line won't change, but the center will change. Center will come like this. So when center comes to C1, when center comes to C1, you have one here. Do you remember? This point is one, right? This one will match with one dash. This two, I mean, when center is C1, one will match with one dash. When it rolls and comes to center C2, okay, this two, this division two, number two, will match with two dash. When center, when the circle comes to center C, okay, center C, this third division is there, right? Three, number three, will match with three dash. Okay, so when it goes to five, this point is there, right? Fifth point will come and match with five dash, and so on. It rolls, right? It rolls. It comes. I mean, one goes downwards, six goes downwards, seven goes downwards, and it rolls like this. As it is rolling like this, all the points 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 12 will come and touch our ground. These points will come and touch our ground. Ultimately, this P also come and touch our ground at Q. So one is coming and touching at one dash, two is coming and touching at two dash, three is coming and touching at three dash. These are the divisions of the same circle. You know, when the circle is touching our ground, these are the numbers indicating the touching point of the circle, particular circle at the particular division. If it is 10, dear students, this 10 is coming, I mean, it is, the circle is rolling like this, the circle is rolling like this, and at a particular time, the 10 also has to touch our ground. Here is the point where 10 touches the ground. When this point 10 is touching the ground, where will be the point P? That is our question. Okay, where will be the point P? So to get that, let us draw some horizontal lines from 6 and from 7 and 7. If you draw a line from 7, it obviously touches 6, that's 5. When you draw from 8, it touches 4. When you draw from 10, it touches 2. When you draw from 11, it touches 1 and comes like this. So here is the ending point, border. Okay, this is ending point. That's it. I hope you are getting this point. Very simple, right? Very, very simple. And now, let me take compass. Okay, when C is the center, you are getting P. Okay, now when C1 is the center, when C1 is the center, you have to get P1. Where you get P1 means, C1 is the center, you have to cut the line which is passing through 1. Here is the line which is passing through 1. So C1 is the center, you have to cut the line which is passing through 1. Let it be P1. P is over and now it is P1. Next, you tell me, you can easily guess that when C2 is the center, you get the point on the line which is passing through 2. This is the line passing through 2. So C2 is the center, you get, okay, P2 here. Okay, radius 25 mm, that you should remember this. Okay, and C3 is the center where is 3, so somewhere here you get P3. And C4 is the center, where is 4? Yes, this is the line passing through 4, so you get let it be here. Okay, this is P4. P5, C5 is the center, you get the point on the line passing through 5, P5. And C6 is the center, you get the point at peaks passing through piece 6 7 you get here, because this is the line coming from 7. 8 you get here, and 9, this itself is the ninth line, you may be getting here. 10, this is the 10th line, so somewhere here. 11 maybe here, and 12 here. So when you join these with the let me use blue pen itself, when you join these all these points, you get a beautiful curve when you use the geometrical tools properly, something like this. So P6 here, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11, this itself is Q12 and P12. This is what cycloid. Okay, I hope you understood this properly. And next extension is, here it is given that 30 mm above the directing line, draw tangent 30 mm above the baseline or directing line. Sometimes he may call it as baseline, sometimes he may call it as directing line. You know what is directing line here? This is our directing line, right? Let me make it a little thick. Okay, this is directing line. From this line, where you have to draw at 30 mm above the directing line. So you can point out 30 mm from this directing line. If you measure here, it may be 5 mm, 10 mm, 20 mm, 30 mm, somewhere here. This side also you get 30 mm. Let me take 30 mm here. It is not about P8 I am taking. Okay, let me take 30 mm here. Here it is 30 mm. Okay, here it is 30 mm. Now let me this is 30 mm, let me take blue black pen for this. This is 30 mm, let me put M, name M. Okay, from this M, this is 30 mm, from here it is 30. Okay, this is 30. Now from here take the radius as 25 mm and with compass cut this center line. So you have cut it with R radius as 25. Okay, and from this point let it be X. Its name will be X. I am putting with black pen because for tangent I am changing the pen. This is X. Okay, from this point you draw a vertical line to this directing line. So very simple, you have marked M at a distance of 30 mm away from this directing line, and from this end, taking this as the center, you have cut this, this center line with a radius 25 and putting the name as X. From this X, you are drawing a vertical line which is perpendicular to directing line, and here you are getting the point N. Okay, and join M and N and extend. Okay, this is N dash, this is normal, N dash normal. Okay, perpendicular to normal is tangent. So draw a perpendicular line to this normal. It may come like this, right? T dash is normal, right? Yes, this is what cycloid. I hope you understood this. But my suggestion is, when I use the pencils, you cannot understand because it is not visible. That is the reason I am using different color pens here. But coming to the pencils, you have to draw this curve with HB pencil. This curve should be highlighted. It should be highlighted. Remaining should be drawn with HR2H pencil. Okay, then only this will be highlighted, because in the question R is given and asked you to draw the cycloid. So what should be highlighted here? The cycloid should be highlighted here. He doesn't ask you to draw the directing line. He doesn't ask you to draw the circle. He doesn't ask you to draw the horizontal lines. He asked you to draw the cycloid. So whatever asked in the examination or in the question, especially whatever asked in the question, that should be highlighted with the HB pencil. That should be highlighted with the HB pencil because that is the answer. Remaining all helping lines. So this is about our cycloid. I hope you understood this. Thank you so much, dear students. Thanks a lot. Keep practicing. Okay, thank you.